So my name's Adam Bulakaitis. I currently live in Kansas City, Missouri, but from Denver, Colorado. I'm currently an Executive Master of Healthcare Administration student at the University of Missouri. I currently also work full-time in addition. I'm a healthcare consultant. Being a part of the healthcare field, you never expect to have to use that knowledge for your own benefit. In 2011, I started experiencing fairly bad headaches to the point where I was very concerned that something wasn't right. I was diagnosed with a small third ventricular tumor that was unfortunately causing obstructive hydrocephalus. It's quite startling to go in one day with headaches and come out the next day with a diagnosis of you have a brain tumor. That's a very scary statement, and that was something that, you know, no one prepares themselves for.
Well, this tumor was located in a compartment of this series of cavities inside the brain, and was itself causing an obstruction of the free flow of fluid. Therefore, there was a buildup of fluid.
Neurosurgeon in Kansas City let me know that they did not recommend a major surgery, that they wanted to put in a shunt to clear the blockage, to reroute the cerebral spinal fluid, and ultimately it would come down to regularly serialized MRIs where they would observe the tumor to make sure that it wasn't growing and that it wasn't aggressive. That didn't sit well with me. I was hoping there was a better answer. I found a number of documents written by a physician out at Johns Hopkins who was talking about a fairly unique procedure to relieve the pressure of these exact types of tumors without the placement of a shunt.
When I saw Adam, he was concerned about the possibility of having a shunt placed, which is obviously a system of hardware that is permanently placed inside the body from the brain into the belly, and therefore subjected to possible malfunctions.
I went to the Johns Hopkins website, and right on there was request a visit. I clicked on the link, and within 2 days I was getting a call. I flew out, cabbed on the next plane, and was in Baltimore being seen by Dr. Levy in his office that very next day. I ultimately came to the decision to pursue the surgery based on my knowledge and based on my knowledge of where the best surgeons were.
We certainly suspected not a very aggressive tumor, but we did not have the confirmation. So the first objective of the procedure was a very thorough assessment of his tumor by a good sampling done through a partial resection, partial removal of his tumor. The second objective was to divert the fluid. We inserted a temporarily small tube with a video camera, and then we were able to open a new passage for the fluid to be reabsorbed. And that allowed him to recover nicely. His headaches certainly disappeared. He can really conduct a normal life without any significant limitations.
I was back up and walking within a week. I was flying within 2 weeks. I was feeling good within 3. And within 4 weeks, I was back to doing the basics. I was back to being myself. So the ceremony tonight is designed to celebrate the success and the end of classes for myself and my colleagues. It was very much a concern of mine that I wouldn't have the ability to graduate on time or get completed in time. And thankfully, because of the way that the surgery was performed, it really minimized the time that I had to recover. I didn't have to delay. I didn't have to push back a year. I didn't have to de-enroll. I'm staying the course. All my follow-up series MRIs have come back clean. They have noticed the scarring as a result of the surgery is looking good. At this point, for all intents and purposes, I'm healed.